Hi, so today I want to chat to you about mental health and how that can be viewed by insurers. So the first thing that you need to consider when you have a mental health issue, just like myself, I've had anxiety issues and a couple of bouts of agoraphobia. Make sure that you're comfortable with the person that you're speaking to. If it's an insurance broker, if it's an insurer, you need to feel confident that you're being listened to properly and that everything that you're being said is being treated with the utmost confidence and empathy. So when it comes to conditions such as stress, whether that's work-related stress or anxiety or depression, with a lot of insurers, you can get that on the standard market. It can often be normal terms, and that's generally depending though upon whether or not you're on medication or not, the strength of the medication, any treatment that you're having, when the diagnosis of the condition was, and how your symptoms are currently. So in a sense, how you're managing your every day-to-day life at the moment with the condition. Then when you start to get to more, what the insurers class as more permanent or severe mental health issues, such as bipolar disorder or borderline personality disorder, that's when, again, you can look on the standard market, but you may want to start being more specific as to which insurers you put your application with, because some are better for different mental health conditions. It is probable that you're going to get some kind of loading on the policy, which means, in general, some kind of premium increase to offset what the insurers see as the additional risk for you having that mental health condition. Then when you go on to the even more severe conditions such as schizophrenia or psychosis, then again the insurer is going to be looking at, again, probably loadings to the policy in the form of premium increases. Depending upon the policies that we're looking at, you may be looking, if it's life insurance, critical illness, income protection, on say the critical illness or the income protection side of things, you may be looking at some exclusions to the claims based upon what your mental health condition is. So I say the insurer's going to want to know the medications that you're on, how often you take them, the dosages, whether or not you've had any inpatient treatment at a hospital. And the insurers are, of course, going to want to know if there has been any suicide attempts or any self-harm. Now, if there have been suicide or self-harm attempts, don't worry. There are policies that are available. On the standard market, you can get policies. It just depends on how often the self-harm occurred or how many suicide attempts there have been and how long the time frame has been since they occurred. And again, how your health is right at this moment in time. If there's been recent health issues, such as a recent suicide attempt, recent self-harm, or any sort of like recent severe changes to your mental health, then it may be that you look at a policy that comes with some exclusions, such as a suicide exclusion, because suicide is generally included on a lot of life insurance policies after the first 12 months of it being in place. So it may end up being that you maybe have that excluded from the policy, or that you want to have a look at a policy that's known as, excuse the insurance jargon, but it's known as non-medically underwritten life insurance, which basically means that your mental health history will have no bearing on the application process or the acceptance terms. But there are restrictions to the policies, and whilst they are fantastic, and they really are fantastic, you need to know the exclusions. You need to know exactly what you are and aren't covered for. So ideally, do speak to somebody who is familiar with these policies and can explain the ins and outs to you. As I say, the main thing is that you feel confident in what you are buying. The last thing you need on top of any mental health issues is any kind of stress that these policies aren't exactly what you're expecting. So I would suggest that you chat with somebody, and as I say, just feel confident that you are getting what you want.